It's me, Crystal, and it is day two of the 7-day self-love challenge. It is such a beautiful day today. It's starting to feel like springtime out there, so I don't know if you guys are out and about enjoying the spring day, but I know that I am ready to get out and go and be out in the sunshine myself. So this is not going to be a very, very, very long video, but I'm going to go ahead and jump right into what I want to talk about today. So, again, today is day two. So, welcome to day two of the 7-Day Self-Love Challenge. I have posted the day two affirmation along with the well work on the Facebook group. So, feel free at any time to post any observations that you have about either the affirmation from yesterday or today's affirmation. And I'm definitely going to continue to post my own observations throughout the week. So you can go on there and you can see what I wrote about yesterday's challenge last night. And I'm going to share a little bit about that as well here today. So so the affirmation for today is, I am willing to embrace the truth of who I am. I'm willing to embrace the truth of who I am. Yesterday we talked about being willing to accept the truth of who I am. And of course, as I go through, you know, my daily life, I'm working on business stuff, there's family stuff, there's, you know, personal, social life, all those kinds of things that come up. And, you know, certainly looking at embracing or looking at accepting the truth of who I am means that I have to accept the things that I don't necessarily like about myself. All right, so this is what happens with live video. Sorry, I had the Wi-Fi turned on, evidently not getting a good Wi-Fi signal. So Wi-Fi is gone. Hopefully, cell phone signal is perfectly fine in here. So anyway, what I was saying is that, you know, looking at accepting the truth of who you are, sometimes it can be difficult because that means accepting everything. You know, that means saying the good and the bad. I accept it all. I am, you know, willing to look at all of those aspects of myself and just be okay. Be okay with all of that. So, so today we're talking about embracing all of the truth of who I am. And sometimes that can be a little bit even more difficult than just accepting it, because that means when we embrace the truth of who we are, that we are almost, it's like taking a look at that little inner child, that little, sometimes that naughty child that's inside, that just needs like some discipline, you know, they just need some extra love, they need some extra attention in order to, you know, kind of get it right, you know, sort of get to that place where they're moving in the directions that are more beneficial. And so that's that part of us that we can actually learn how to embrace and learn how to, you know, really give that love to. So with this exercise, it's just kind of a step-by-step progression. I'm just taking a look at, you know, well, if I am willing to embrace the truth of who I am, then let me do that now. If I'm not willing to embrace the truth of who I am, why not? What are the things about myself that I feel, you know, there might be a problem with, or that, you know, there's a problem for me that I'm judging myself on, right? So the activity for today, again, just like this, will be for every day, will be to just think about it, contemplate it as you're going about your business. You might want to, you know, think about it today. We're going to do a guided meditation here in just a few minutes. But just really tune in to that inner voice, that inner guidance that's saying, you know, yes, I embrace the truth of who I am because this, this, and this. No, I really can't embrace that about myself. That definitely has to change before I can love myself, right? But you're going to think about those things. You're going to observe those things without judging them, without filtering anything, and just write down or record in some fashion those, all of those feelings that come up. And then at the end of the week, I'm going to have a very powerful technique that I'm going to share with you for how you can really supercharge those thoughts and feelings and create a scenario for yourself where you're bringing more love into your life and you're actually giving yourself this energy of change that we all so desperately desire and that we so desperately want and need. I have, had some conversations today with people about, all variety of different issues that they have going on in their lives. And the one thing, the one common thread that kind of seems to be weaving its way through all of it is this need to really embrace ourselves, to really learn how to love ourselves, and to really acknowledge that we are, in fact, infinite love, that that is by virtue of our intrinsic value, that's who we are. So today I want to, in addition to that, I want to talk a little bit about some basis of understanding, some basic truths that we really need to sort of start to incorporate into the way that we go about our life and the way that, our perception of the world is. And these basic understandings, these basic truths will help us in this journey of becoming more love for ourselves. So I actually did post this this list on the Facebook group the other day. A few of you clicked a like on it. If there are any points that you disagree with, please share. Tell me what your thoughts are about it and why. Because when we start to look at these things, they will bring up issues that we are, that we're struggling with, or they may bring up our thoughts of our opinions, our control of things. So the first thing that is a basic understanding is that everything is energy. Everything is vibration, frequency, and codes. So from every energy, every color, every sound that you hear, every solid thing, everything in your body, everything that's happening is basis. The basis of everything is an energy, a frequency, a vibration. Okay, so that is a foundational truth. The second thing is I am responsible for my own energy. Just me, nobody else. Number three, I am experiencing life through the lens of my own energy, my unique perspective. I only experience life through my lens of my own energy, through these eyes. What I see, what I perceive is all based on my own energy, and that's how I'm perceiving life. Number four, just like a drop in the ocean is still ocean, I am infinite love. I am an individual expression of that expansive, infinite energy that we know as infinite love, infinite life, source, God, universal, whatever name you want to give it. That's a part of me, just like that little drop of ocean water is still the ocean. Number five, I always have a choice. I always have a choice. It may seem like I'm in a situation that I don't have a choice. I'm being, for whatever reason, I feel that there's only one thing that I can do in this situation. In every situation, there are choices. And I always have the ability to choose. Again, these are concepts that are basis of truth. So if there's a question about that, then from your life experiences, you can't wrap your brain around that. Let's talk about it. Let's find out like what's really going on. All right, the next one, number six, I am a perfectly imperfect, unique individual. The way that I am designed is perfect, even with all of its imperfections. The way that I'm here to be, authentically stepping into my truth, is perfect. Number, let's see what that was. Number six, number seven, I am intrinsically connected to infinite wisdom. When I say intrinsically, that means that there is a bond between myself and infinite wisdom that cannot be broken, even if I'm unable to perceive it, even if I'm unable to connect in with it consciously, it's always there and it will always be there and it always has been there. Number eight, I am not responsible for anyone else's energy. Enough said. Number nine, I am the driver and the passenger of my own vehicle consciousness. Number 10, my driver is my subconscious, unconscious self, and I act according to the expression of my own subconscious energy as a shadow, a gift, or in a self-mastered state. So, again, if there's any questions about any of these things, feel free to ask those questions and we will dive in and gain more clarity about what all this means. Number 11, I am capable of achieving all of my goals when they are aligned with my soul level intentions. As long as I'm tuned in to the frequency of my own soul in love, I can achieve anything that my soul is guiding me to achieve. And number 12, there are certain universal truths that are always in action, including the law of attraction. Okay. And 13, there is a benevolent intelligence to the universe that is for me. A benevolent intelligence to the universe that is for me. It's for me. All right. So those are a few, well, more than a few, 13 different aspects of basic truth that I believe, in my experience, has been very critical and instrumental in bringing me to an awareness of deeper self-love, an embodiment of self-love, and being able to be an expression of the love that I am into the world. And so, yeah, I think that's pretty much what I want to share today. So I'm gonna flip over here and see if there were any comments. Nope, no comments. So without any further delay, I'm gonna jump right into doing a self-love meditation where we are all going to bring all of our energy together to really dive in and feel the frequency of this affirmation today. Okay? So I just invite you to take a couple of deep breaths and get relaxed wherever you are. If you're driving or something like that, of course, you don't want to close your eyes, but you can listen and take some deep breaths and just really tune into your own body. Tune in to all of the amazing things that your body is doing right now. It's beating your heart, breathing the air. It's turning oxygen into carbon dioxide with every breath. Inhaling fresh O2 to empower and charge your cells. Releasing the byproduct of that, which is waste product, out your lungs through the breath. Amazing that your body does this every moment of every day. All of the millions and trillions and bajillions of functions and systems and motions and movements and things that are happening in your body right now. You don't even have to control any of that. The truth of who you are is a being, a body that just has infinite ability, infinite wisdom. And that is something to be grateful for. That is something to embrace. I am willing to embrace the truth of who I am. And so just continue to breathe in that space of gratitude and appreciation for your body, your physical form. And tune your attention into wherever in your body you feel like your consciousness is, and maybe in your head or in your heart. And just begin to notice what you notice there. As you breathe, allowing the pressure of your thoughts to just fade. Without any judgment of what is actually coming up, what thoughts and feelings are coming up for you. Maybe your thoughts and feelings are, this is all bullshit. That's okay. Record that. Observe that. Ask yourself why. I'm here for a reason. And maybe that reason is to discover something new about myself. Just really always knew it was there, but maybe I just ignored it, maybe I dismiss it, or maybe I just let it run in the background. And it colors all of my perceptions. And I'm willing to let that come forth right now. And to give it a voice, to let it tell me what it wants me to know. Somebody's having a breakthrough right now, listening to that voice, and just let it rant. And let it tell you all the negative self-talk that you've heard your whole life, that on some level you know is BS, because it doesn't resonate with feelings of love. Doesn't resonate with feelings of goodness. It doesn't resonate with the truth of your being, the light that's inside you. And it's there. And there's an opportunity to let it teach you. Show you where you're broken so that you can begin to heal and turn your light up and let your light shine a little bit brighter every day. Take another deep cleansing breath. This is a process that may shake things up a little bit. It might get a little uncomfortable. But that's okay too. Be willing to embrace all of it. And know that you're worthy of the changes that you really want to make. I am willing to embrace the truth of who I am. I'm willing to embrace the truth. I'm willing. It's really all it takes. I feel some energy moving through the heart space now. There's some stuff kind of being chipped away and kind of broken into in the heart center. As you say to yourself, I'm willing. I am willing. I'm willing to love myself more. How do I do that? Just by being willing to embrace my truth. Just take a few more breaths. thoughts in this space, this energy, as I begin to bring infinite love into this meditation and dial it up, amplify by 100 times the love that I am. Same energy. We have all have the same ability to embody love. So take one more deep cleansing breath. And toes, and open your eyes. And I just invite you to share whatever came up for you. You're more than welcome to private message me. You are more than welcome to be as vulnerable as you would like to be. I think that this is a very safe space for you to be who you are. No judgment. No fear, no doubt, just open up, let your light shine, and share your thoughts and feelings, because this is a healing place, and it's about change, it's about growth, it's about willingness. So I thank you guys for joining me today. I'm going to slide over here and see if there's any comments. Nope, no comments. So, even after I end the broadcast, feel free to post your comments and questions if you have any, and definitely feel free to post your observations of what's coming up for you as you say these affirmations. Tomorrow we're going to talk to, first of all, let me say tomorrow we're going to talk about clearing emotional baggage as it comes up and giving you some specific tools that you can use to clear the emotional baggage. Sometimes we have stuff that's stuck in there that's not even ours, you know, our grandparents, our parents, you know, some of that stuff is generational. We don't even know that we're walking around with, you know, negative thoughts and feelings and energies. So I'm going to share some ways to clear that information out of the way so that you can really begin to deepen and embody this energy. And also tomorrow, there is a special broadcast. I'm going to go live at 5 o'clock tomorrow. It's not going to be on Facebook though. It's going to be on Zoom. So you're going to need to get the link for the Zoom meeting. I'm going to be talking with my friend Keith Coley about a really powerful Qigong practice of cultivating qi in your body. And it's a very healing practice. Again, it's about bringing more love, more light into your body. And so you don't want to miss that. Keith is an amazing person, and he's super funny and has a really great personality too. And so it's going to be a really fun conversation, and we're just going to give you guys some information about that. So that's going to be at 5 o'clock tomorrow, Tuesday. Make sure you look for the link. And if you want the link and you can't find it, please ask me for it, and I will make sure that you get the link. Okay, so that's going to be tomorrow at 5. So moving forward for the rest of the challenge, today is the only day that I can actually do this after 5. So I'm going to continue to do these live streams at 1 o'clock, 1:11. If you can't get there to watch me live, that's okay. I understand. I won't take it personal. And I will be recording, and so you can catch the recordings and then hopefully do the challenge. Okay? All right, so I'm gonna sign off now, and I will catch up with you guys later. Much love, namaste, and bless you.